So week 6 was a pretty weird slate, but I think with week 7 we have some more clarity. In this video, I'm going to be looking at my week 7 picks at each position and at different price points, starting with quarterback, where my expensive option is Lamar Jackson. He's going into a decent matchup against Seattle with easily the highest floor of any quarterback given his production on the ground. Last week, he had over 33 DraftKings points without throwing a single touchdown, as he almost broke the single game rushing record for a quarterback. Aside from one week, he scored over 20 DraftKings points and is averaging almost 77 rushing yards a game. His high floor is very obvious, but he has just as much upside as any other quarterback on this slate, but you're going to have to pay up to $6,800 if you want him. My pick for a mid-price guy is going to be Jared Goff. He had a rough week last week, but going against Atlanta, it's the perfect position to bounce back as they give up the most points to quarterbacks this season. This game could easily shoot out with all the players you can stack with Goff. I'm definitely going to have a lot of exposure. Another guy worth mentioning in this tier is going to be Danny Dimes in a great matchup against Arizona. I'm not sure if you need to go down at quarterback this week with the value at other positions, but if you're going to, I think Minshew is your best bet in a matchup versus Cincinnati that bleeds points to the quarterback position. The only thing that's probably going to keep my ownership pretty low is the amount I'm playing Fournette this week. But with that said, because of Fournette's volume in the passing game, these two can have a great game together and makes for some interesting GPP options. Going to running back, my high price option is going to be Leonard Fournette. If you're playing cash, he's going to be pretty close to a lock with what appears to be a floor of 25 touches in a great matchup versus Cincinnati, and he surprisingly hasn't hit that 8K price tag, so we need to take advantage of the value while we have it. He's decently cheap to be considered my high price pick, but I don't think anyone ahead of him is going to receive any more volume, so I don't see a need to pay up, especially in cash. For a medium price guy, I'm going with Chris Carson, who since putting the fumbles behind him, has gotten over 25 touches in the past 3 weeks, where he's hit the 100-yard bonus in each. He's in a nice matchup against Baltimore, who isn't the defense we are used to this year. He's at home in a game that has a pretty high total. This slate is shaping up pretty well with the amount of touches you can get at running back without really sacrificing at any other position. For a low price guy, I'm going with Josh Jacobs. There's a lot of value in this 5K range this week at running back with guys like Kerryon Johnson and Devontae Freeman. But right now, I'm liking Jacobs, who's the cheapest of the three. He had a great week one, but failed to crack 13 fantasy points in the next 3 weeks. But 2 weeks ago, against one of the league's best defenses in the Chicago Bears, got 32 points on 26 carries, where he went off for 123 yards and 2 touchdowns. I think coming out of the bye week against a team in the Green Bay Packers that's given up some big games to running backs, the Raiders are going to look to establish their run game. We've also seen an increased for him in the passing game, getting 7 targets over the past 3 weeks. Now he's far from a chalk, and I'm fine with the other guys in this range like we mentioned before, but right now I am leaning towards Jacobs. Going to wide receiver, my favorite high price guy is going to be Cooper Kupp. On the season, he's already got 69 targets, which sets the floor so high, especially in this matchup against Atlanta. The whole Rams offense struggled last week, and Cooper Kupp only finished with 5.7 points, but I think that week's actually helping him this week, as we're not getting some massive price jump like we probably would have saw with just like a 15-point outing. In cash, you're trying to get the most touches, you're trying to get the most targets, so at 7,400, Kupp is pretty chalky this week. For my medium pick, I'm going down to 5,500 for John Brown. We are getting some reports that he was limited in midweek practice, but if he's ready to go, I'm going to have a lot of exposure. Aside from week one, he hasn't had a big game, but he's gotten 39 targets through 5 weeks. He's got Josh Allen back, and he's going against the freaking Dolphins. Miami gives up a ton of big plays, and if that's happening for the Bills on Sunday, there's a good chance Brown is involved. For a low price guy, there isn't that super obvious value play like we saw with Auden Tate or Nelson Agholor in previous weeks, but this can change as the week progresses. If nothing does change though, some sub 5K guys I like would be D.D. Westbrook in a nice matchup and should see a solid amount of looks. DK Metcalf in what could be a high scoring game and obviously has that big play ability, or Cole Beasley, who's seen a ton of targets and just like Brown is playing the freaking Dolphins. Now Beasley could become a great play by the end of the week if Brown is a no-go. I also like Christian Kirk against the Giants at 5K if he's playing. Now, if Davante Adams and Geronimo Allison are out for the Packers, Alan Lazard might become ultimate chalk at 3K, who had a great game on Monday night versus the Lions. For tight end, my high price guy is going to be Evan Ingram. It's hard to play him with the value at this position, but going against the Cardinals, who have given up the most points to tight ends this season, his upside is extremely high. Just simply from the fact that he's going to be in a high-paced matchup and he's the number one target, he's a great play, but adding what the Cardinals have done against tight ends, he should be in for a very great game, but you're going to have to pay up to $6,700 if you want him. For a medium price player, I'm going to go with Mark Andrews. He's been Lamar's go-to guy and is now fully healthy. You're getting him at 4,800 in a high total game against a team that hasn't been great against tight ends, with the potential to stack him with Lamar Jackson. All this combined makes him a very solid play this week. For a low price guy, we're going with Hunter Henry at 4K. Back from injury, he looked like Rivers' go-to guy on Sunday night, grabbing 8 catches on 9 targets for 100 yards and 2 touchdowns. Now, obviously, no one is expecting that kind of production, as we are going to see more targets come back to Keenan Allen, but at 4K, you only need a fraction of that for him to meet his value. For defense, I don't want to spend too much time on it with the amount of variance, but for a high price one, I'm going with the Bills against the Dolphins because they're playing the Dolphins. For a medium price one, you're going to go with the Chicago Bears at 3K. I don't know why they got priced down to 3K. They haven't been crazy in terms of fantasy, but they're still a great defense at home going against New Orleans. And for a low price one, I think you have the Colts undervalued at 2K. They've been pretty solid this season, especially going at the quarterback, and are going to be going against the Texans, who have struggled protecting Deshaun Watson. But that's it for you guys. You guys tell me your thoughts in the comments below. If you liked the video, make sure you like and subscribe, and peace.